fires it over to Rasmus Anderson out to center ice. That's intercepted by Lindell. Pavelski fires the pass across. Here's a chance for Hintz. Stopped by Markstrom. Stopped the rebound, too, as Robertson jams away. They score the third chance. Tucked in top shelf by Joe Pavelski. Minute five in. Two stops. Third one winds up in the net, and the Dallas Stars take a 1-0 lead.
Play by the Flames to get the puck away on this pass. Right through the middle of Novak. And that creates the counterattack. Now a wonderful first pass by Pavelski and Hintz with the first chance. And now it's a scrum. Where's the puck? Nobody can find it except the guy that always does in front of the net. And that's Pavelski, who is so good at picking up loose pucks in this area. Look at him come late. Just waiting until that puck arrives.
Sagan 30 stitches.
Delandria trying to work it out in front. He's knocked down. Slides the puck back to the line. Suter will put it down low. Markstrom cuts it off, chips it up the boards, picked off though. Here's Foxa, hits with a shot stop. They score on the rebound, right? Foxa puts it home. And it's 2-0 Dallas, less than 2 minutes into the opening period.
Markstrom will go behind the net. He'll field the puck, and unfortunately, he hits the ref right in the shin. That creates the giveaway. And then the chance, first of all, Markstrom with the first good save is Ben Rifles, and he's got a good shot. It's one thing to get him right in the slots. Pardon me. And there's the rebound there after the initial shot by Hintz, lets it rip, and then the rebound. You can see Markstrom's reaction here. He is not happy. As Plastic picks it, gets the rebound, and goes right to the net.
Nadonov waiting for it. Checked by Hanifin, who steals. And Lewis, at the end of a shift, puts it back in deep. Ottinger feeds the puck into the corner. Lundqvist. That's picked off by Toffoli. Here's Mangiapane with a shot. Ottinger says, rebound, they score! Lindholm fires it home. And it's a one-goal game as the Flames are on the board.
And here's the initial play. Good play by Ottinger. He'll go to his D-man, and here's the giveaway. Right through the middle of the ice to Toffoli. The Stars are on a bit of a change here, and that creates the bad advantage. Bring Mangiapane with the first chance. He throws it towards the net. Ottinger lets the rebound out. And Johnny on the spot right there is Lindholm, and that gets some life for the Flames and gets some break back in it after the initial giveaway that Toffoli found.
Just try to scramble it. If you're not going to win it, don't lose it like that, even if you can tie it. See what happens this time.
Ben against Kadri, another win for the Stars. Haskinen takes a look again. Shot tipped, they score! Tipped in front by Ben, who won the faceoff. And then redirects one home to make it 3-1 Dallas with 3:52 to go in the period.
Wait until I get in position. And you'll watch Ben, he'll just pull it out and redirect it there. And it goes right over top of Markstrom. And is it? And Ben and Johnson both together reach for it. And I don't think either one knows who got it. Now look at Haskinen, just look and shoot for the tip. Yeah, that's, it'll be interesting to see who they give credit.
Playback underway, Weegar works his way towards the ball. Oh, scores! Mackenzie Weegar cuts the lead to one. And that's goals and back-to-back games for Weegar, his third of the season. And a big goal for the Calgary Flames here in the second period.
You know, I talked to Weegar this morning, and he says it's really helped him that Anderson's paired with him because he's the offensive guy. But now all of a sudden, now Weegar, who's normally the defensive guy, comes in after a face-off win, and he'll just walk right in down the side and beat Ottinger there with good traffic by Anderson, the other defenseman who goes right in front of the net. And you'll see him come right in from his position, Anderson. So now you got 2D in the offensive.
Makes a play to Backlund behind the net. Has to knock it down off the top of the wall. Flips it back to the point to Weegar. Weegar feeds it over. Here's Anderson with a lane. Anderson right in. Stopped by Ottinger. Oh, he's gone! Coleman cuts it in. Instincts prove. And Blake Coleman has tied the game of three.
And here he is. One hand. Gets it back to the point. And now the Stars are chasing, and I mean chasing, as Hintz went from one side to the other side of the ice, and then Coleman, after Anderson, walks right in wide open because of the Stars moving all over the map. The puck goes through Ottinger, and here goes Coleman. Look at how he gets position, wide open, and tucks it in.
Tipped ahead to Ben, trying to take advantage, flips it through, and Dodonov couldn't get to it. It winds up on goal. Markstrom knocks that away. Rasmus Anderson now with a long pass. Here's a breakaway. It's Richie. Right in. Scores! Nick Richie puts it home, and the Flames have taken the lead.
the puck. Hannafin gets it to him. They win the battle. What a pass. Right to Richie, who somehow gets sneaks in behind the defense. How about those hands? Comes across, comes in 5-hole. And here's that pass. Tape to tape. And Richie here with a beautiful little finish.
Fires the puck in deep. Markstrom will stop that behind the net. Make a pass to the corner. Intercepted by Roope Hintz. Bounces behind the net. Robertson protects the puck with a play back towards Miller. Let it go. Turned away by Markstrom. Another shot stopped by Markstrom. Rebound. They score. Robertson ties it up as he puts it home on the second rebound. And we're all even at 4. Finishes it off.
But here's a little play down low. Now Miller's got a bomb. So he'll fight it from the point after Robinson wins the battle. And Markstrom has a difficult time controlling the rebound. And then right in front, Pavelski, as usual, creates havoc for Markstrom on the second save. And he can't quite hold on the rebound. And then guess who comes in late?
A lot of points that you miss. If you even split that, you'd be in the playoffs right now.
Weegar plays the puck in deep. Walker Dewar takes the puck. Otten has lost his stick. Anderson tries to take advantage. Scores! A shot by Anderson. A stickless Ottinger can't make the save. And the Flames are back on top 5-4.
He's been tremendous. And Ottinger here will lose his goal stick. There. As Dewar just sort of collides with him. And then the puck goes back to the point. Dewar does it all. And then through traffic, Ottinger never sees it.
Miller shovels it back behind his own net. Lindell is there. Cut off by Dewar, but it'll hop off his stick. Now Ben breaks out. Three wide. Pavelski and Johnston with him. Ben, shot blocked. Lines up bouncing in front. Comes back. Pocket ball. Stop. Score. Off Markstrom and in. Puck bouncing around. Winds up on the stick of Yanni Hockenbaugh. Put it off the goaltender and into the net to tie it back up at 5.
Well, this is a harmless looking play, but look at Jamie Benn here. I mean, he just takes off after Dewar loses the puck on the half board. The Flames have numbers back. They're all right here. But then they collapse down low, everybody, including Richie. And when they do that, they're puck watching. And Hockenbaugh ends up in position 8. Watch all the Flames. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right down low. That leaves the defenseman wide open. It goes through Markstrom, who is moving out.
Roope hits. Hintz drops it off to Robertson with a shot and put it wide. Around the boards, picked up far side, flipped toward the goal. Anderson cut it off. And this game is headed to overtime. It's time. And Hintz wins the draw. Pavelski gets the puck. There with Hintz and Robertson. Long pass to Robertson. Hintz goes for the goal. Robertson, nice move. Backhand scores. Robertson on the backhand wins it in overtime. Stars 6-5 over the Flames in Calgary.
Let's see what happens here. Well, it's close to offside. And there is an unbelievable effort by Robertson there. I mean, that's spectacular. So now the officials are going to go over as the and they're going to have a peek here. Remember, this is in lead control now.
See if it might be goalie interference here as well.
No, well, I think it's more the offside, to be honest with you. It was really close.
Hintz didn't touch Markstrom.